What's up, Legend of Korra fans? Thanks for tuning in. Basically, I'm going to do a quick video review of the new Korra game, Republic City Run. What I'm going to do is just sort of tell you guys a little bit about the game, some personal opinions on it, and you can also watch some of the gameplay on the screen. Anyway, let's get started. This game was released on the Nickelodeon website, where you can go ahead and play for free. And basically, you play the game as Korra in different maps and levels. And the objective is to run the farthest distance without getting hit by the enemies. So per round of gameplay, you have 3 lives and you want to make sure that you get the farthest, of course, without getting hit 3 times. Along the way, you can go ahead and collect coins or yuans, and later on at the end of the game, you can use these coins or yuans to buy, you know, upgrades, power-ups, things like that for the next round of game you play. Also, one of the cool things about this game is that, you know, if you get, you know, 200 meters the first time you play, and, you know, you play next time, you get 250 meters, that's a new record right there. So it's going to go ahead and say new record. So that, I thought that was pretty nice that it saves your previous records, so you don't have to start all over every time. And that sort of gives you the motivation to keep on playing, kind of keep on breaking your records. Also, the enemies that you can come at, you can also sort of bend elements at them, pressing spacebar, it'll just randomly release earth, water, fire, and air, pretty simple enough, using your energy bar, which is down below. It keeps refilling itself, so it's not like you're gonna run out of energy to element, but that's that. So that's basically the game, how it works and stuff. My personal opinions on it is I think it's pretty good for an action game on Nickelodeon. I think they did a decent job. However, I think that they should have added more characters that you could have chosen from in the beginning, because playing as Korra is nice, but you know, you kind of maybe wanted to play as Bolin or Mako, Asami, think people like that. You know, they could have put like, oh, different characters have different, you know, speeds or bending speeds and things like that. So I think that would have been nice if they added that. Anyway, guys, this is an end of the review. I just wanted to make it quick, not too long, so hope you guys are still here by now. Anyway, I'm planning on doing more podcasts and reviews, so if this gets good feedback, then I'll think of that. So if give it a thumbs up if you liked it, you know, more positive feedback, more chances of me making it, because I want to see if you guys like it or not. Anyways, guys, comment below if you played it. Tell me how you guys feel. If you haven't played it, go ahead and check it out. There's a link in the description. Follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook. Korra updates on those constantly. Also, check out my website, which is I post regular information and news about Legend of Korra, you know, release dates, rumors, things like that. Anyways, guys, I'll see you guys later. Be sure to subscribe to stay in touch for more videos.